I grew up through the war years, so I experienced the ghetto when I was very young. I never attended school because I was too young. You didn't quite understand what was going on. You knew that there was danger. You knew that you had to hide. You knew that if somebody took you away, it was very dangerous. So you lived in fear. And the topic of conversation was who was taken away, who was shot. And we listened to it and we accepted it as a norm, to be honest. The Germans or the Ukrainians came looking for kids who were obviously hiding. So we were all very attuned to the fact that the minute you heard a noise, you had to crawl under the bed. In my case, I crawled into a drawer of a cupboard, which my father took the bottom out, and I stayed there until the noise, whoever was there, I didn't see who was there, but I heard someone coming. So that was a survival. The Jewish women were not allowed to go to the market to buy anything or shop. So there were a lot of Polish peasants who used to come and sell goods. One day a lady turned up. She was a janitor of a small block of flats in the middle of the city. And she took a particular liking to my mother. When the news came out that they're closing the ghetto and everybody is being shipped out, she said to my mother, I want you to come to stay with me. In today's terms, it was a small bedroom. But when my father took me there, Stasha, her name was Stasha, didn't want to accept me because it was very dangerous. My mother said, look, she's not going to let me go. If she won't accept me, my mother will leave too. And anyway, she relented and she said I could stay. And she let my father stay too. So there were us three and her living in that apartment. We were there for about 2 years until the end of the war. When the Russians came and we were liberated, I couldn't walk down. My legs had been atrophied. My father had to carry me down because I simply couldn't manage the stairs. Except for miracles, I honestly cannot say why it was that we survived, why it was that Stasha wanted to keep us at risk to her life, because she really didn't get anything out of it. I suppose we all want to feel important and we want to feel good. When we arrived in this country, my parents and me, and we sat down to Friday night dinner, and then when there was a big holiday, like Pesach, we sat down and we had six of us, because there was my aunt and my uncle and a cousin. And when I look today, that when I sit down and there are 17 of us around the table, I think it's a proof to resilience and the fact that we will survive.